Dear students, welcome to another video tutorial on data structure and algorithm. And today's topic is binary searching technique. My name is Niladri Shekhar Pal. I am working as an assistant professor at Greater Kolkata College of Engineering and Management. The college is under GIS Group Educational Initiative and the college is situated at Barwipur. So what is binary searching? Binary search algorithm basically finds a given element in a list of elements with order of log n time complexity, where n is the total number of elements in the list. Binary search is a first search algorithm with runtime complexity of order of log n. This search algorithm works on the principle of divide and conquer. For this algorithm to work properly, the data collection should be in the sorted form. Binary search looks for a particular item by comparing the middlemost item of the collection. If a match occurs, then the index of the item is returned. If the middle item is greater than the item, then the item is searched, okay, in the subarray to the left of the middle item. Otherwise, the item is searched for in the subarray to the right of the middle item. This process continues on the subarray as well until the size of the subarray reduces to zero. The binary search algorithm can be used with only a sorted list of elements. That means the binary search is used only with a list of elements that are already arranged in an order. The binary search cannot be used for a list of elements arranged in random order. This search process starts comparing the search element with the middle in the list. Okay? If both are matched, then the result is element found. Okay? Otherwise, we will check whether the search element is smaller or larger than the middle element in the list. If the search element is smaller, then we repeat the same process for the left sub list of the middle element. Okay. If the search element is larger, then we repeat the same process for the right sub list of the middle element. We repeat this process until we find the search element in the list or until we left with a sub list of only one element. And if that element also does not match with the search element, then the result is element not found in the list. Okay. So what are the steps of binary searching? Okay. So for a binary search to work, it is mandatory for the target array to be sorted. Okay. So all the elements must be in sorted. It may be in ascending or descending. Okay. But it may be sorted. We will learn the process of binary search with a pictorial representation. Okay, so let's do it. So at the step one, we will read the search element from the user. Okay, so the search element will be taken through keyboard. Next, in the second step, we will find the middle element in the sorted list. Okay, so we will find the middle element then. Okay, so the formula of the middle element is low plus high by 2. Okay, next we will compare the search element with the middle element in the sorted list. If both are matched, then we'll display given element is found and terminate the function. In the next step, if both are not matched, then we will check whether the search element is smaller or larger than the middle element. Okay, in the next step, if the search element is smaller than the middle element, we will repeat step 2, 3, 4 and 5 for the left sublist of the middle element. Okay. So these are the important steps. In the step number 7, if the search element is larger than the middle element, we will repeat the same steps of 2, 3, 4 and 5 for the right hand part of the middle element. Okay, and in the step 8, we will repeat the same process until we find the search element in the list or until the sub list contains only one element. Okay, so we'll do it until there is only one element, or we will find the desired output. If that element also does not match with the search element, then we will display element is not found in the list and terminate the function. Okay, so we will consider the following list of elements and the element to be searched. As you can see that there is an example of binary search. Okay, as you can see, all the elements here are in the sorted form. Okay, as you can see, 10, 12, 20, 32, 50, 55, okay, 65, 80, 99, all are in the sorted form, and these are the index values. Okay, this is the position, basically position number. Okay, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Okay, and here 0 is the low and 8 is the high. Okay, so we have to searching element our is 12. Okay, so in the step 1 we will find out the mean, and the formula is low plus high by 2, that is low is 0 and high is 8, so mean will be 0 plus 8 by 2. Okay, so middle is 4. Okay, so now we will check whether, okay, so the middle is this one. Okay, so now we will check whether the element in the middle position is equal to the searching element or not. This is the first condition. Okay, so in the first condition we will check whether the middle element will be similar to the searching element or not. If it is same as the searching element, then we can say conclude that element found. But if it is not similar to the searching element, then we will check whether the searching element is greater than middle or less than middle. Okay, so in step 1 we will check whether the middle element is equal to the searching element or not. If it is yes, then we will say that the element is found. Okay, but if it is not same, then we have basically two conditions: whether the mid element or the searching element is greater than the mid element or less than the mid element. In this case, our mid element is 50. Okay, and the searching element is 12. Okay, so we can say that it is not same. Okay, so we will check whether 12 is greater or less than 50. So 12 is basically less than 50. Okay, so 12 is less than 50. So our new list will be this one. Okay, so our new list will be this one. Okay, so as you can see that this is our new list. Okay, so in this list 0 is the low and 3 is the high. Okay, so this low is same as the previous low. Okay, but high is changed. High is basically mid minus 1. Okay, so the value of high is mid minus 1. If the searching element was greater than 50, that part I will discuss in our next example. Okay, so we can say that the 12 is less than. Okay, so the list, new list will be this one. Okay, so then it is the new list. Okay, so here low is 0 and high is 3. Okay, so in the step 2, low is 0 and high is 3. Okay, and the middle element is low plus high by 2, that is low is 0, high is 3. So 0 plus 3 by 2, that is 1. Okay, So this is our middle element. Okay. So our first step is to check whether the middle element is equal to the searching element or not. Okay. So in this case, the middle element is equals to the searching element. Okay. So we can conclude that element found at position 1. Okay. So we have found the element at position 1. Okay. So this is how we will search an element in using binary search. Okay. So let's do another example. Okay. So this is the list. Okay. This is the searching element 80. Okay. Because you can see that all the elements are in the sorted order. So now the searching element is this 80. So this is the step 1. Low is 0 and high is 8. Okay. So we'll find out mid. Mid will be 4. So now this is the 4. Okay. So 50 is the mid element. Okay. So now we will check whether the mid element is equals to the searching element or not. Okay. So in this case, the mid element is not equal to the searching element. And in the next step, we will check whether the searching element is greater than mid element or less than mid element. Okay. So in this case, as we can see that the searching element is greater than the mid element. Okay. So our new list will be this one. Okay. This is our new list. Okay. So as you can see that in this case, in the previous example, we have seen that when the new list is at the left hand side of the middle element, then the value of high has changed and the value of high become mid minus 1. Okay. So, but in this case, if the searching element is at the right hand side of the mid element, then we will increase the value or will change the value of low. We will change or increase the value of low by mid plus 1. So new low will be mid plus 1. Okay. So, okay. So this is the new list. Okay. So now the low is 5 and high is 8. Okay. So now the low value is 5. And the value of high is 8. Okay. So in the step 2, we will again find the mid. Mid is 5 plus 8 by 2, that is 13 by 2, and 13 by 2 is 6. Okay. So we will not take the decimal part, okay, as it is the integer. Now this is the middle element. Middle is now 6 position. Okay, so the middle element is 65. Okay, so we will check whether the middle element is equal to 80 or not, is searching element or not. Okay, but in this case the middle element is 65 and the searching element is 80. Okay, so we can say that these are not same. Okay, so next we will check whether 65 is less than or 80 is less than 65 or greater than 65. Okay, or the searching element is less than 65 or greater than 65. But in this case we can say that the searching element is greater than the mid element. Okay, so this will be our new list. Okay, so the value of mid has been increased by 1. Okay, so the new low is now 8. Okay, new low is 7 and high is same as previous, that is 8. Okay, so in this step 3, our low is 7 and high is 8. So we'll find the middle. Middle is 7. Okay, so in the 7th position, the element is 80. Okay, so 80 will be compared with the searching element, that is 80. We can see that both the elements are same. So we can conclude that the element is found. Okay, so this is how we will find any element. Okay, or search any element using binary search. Okay, so now we'll do a C program. which will implement binary search. Okay, so let's do the program. Okay, so this is our C editor. Okay, we'll go to the file section, then new. Okay, this is the source file. Okay, so we'll write the code. Yeah. Okay. So at first we'll take the element. Okay. So we'll first take the hash include stdio.h. This is the header file basically. Okay. All C standard input output header file. Okay. All the C library functions are defined within this header file. Okay. Next hash include pronio.h. Next we'll take a function int main. Okay. So this is the main function. Any C program, okay, must have a single main function. Okay, because any C program will start executing from this main function. Okay. So int C is the variable. Next first last middle and comma search. Again we will take an array. Okay. Array is 100. So these are the variables. Okay. Now we will take how many elements we want to take in the array. That is printf. So slash n, enter the number of elements. Next scanf using the double quotation percentage d comma ampersand in. Okay, so this is the number of elements. Next we will enter the elements of the array. Okay. So printf slash n enter the elements of the array. So now take a look for c equals to 0. Less than n, c plus plus. So scanf percentage d comma ampersand array c. Okay. It will store the elements into the array. Okay. So now we will take the integer that we want to search. Okay. Slash n, enter the element. To be searched. Okay. So scan it. Percentage d comma and person search. So we have already taken the elements in the array and also taken the element we want to search. Okay, so right now the value of first variable is 0. Okay. And the value of last variable is also basically n minus 1. Okay, n minus 1 because we have started from 0. Okay, so the middle element will be first, last, by 2. Okay. So we have found the middle one. Okay. So if the number of element is 10, okay, so it will be 0 plus 9 by 2, that is 4. Okay. So next we'll take the while. If first is less than equals to last, that means if the if area is there any element or not. Okay. Within the while there is an if array of middle is less than such we can say that first equals to middle last one. Okay. So at first if array middle is less than equals to such, okay, so the value of middle will be new value. I want to say that new first of new array will be middle plus 1. Okay. Under the else if condition we will write whether if array middle is whether equals to such or not. Okay. So array middle whether equal such or not. If it is, okay, then we can print it that element found. Okay, we can say that element found. Okay, so this is the else part, and after that we will use the break statement. Okay, so once we have found the element, we need not required to check other values. Okay, so in the else part, that is if array middle is greater than the search element. So the else part we will check whether last is equals to middle minus 1. Okay. And middle will be, this is the outside the else loop. Okay. So the outside middle will be first last by 2. This is the end of the while loop. Okay, so in the outside of the while loop we can write that if first is greater than last, we can say that printf slash n element not found. So element not found. So this was the code of binary searching. Okay. So let's first run the program, then we'll discuss it. Okay. I will first save the program, save as. Is binary dot c. Okay. We have saved it. Okay. So let's execute the program. This is compile and run. Okay. So the number of elements, suppose it is 5. Okay, the elements are suppose 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay. The searching element is suppose 3. Element found. Okay. So this was the program to find out any elements of an array using binary search. Okay. So let's discuss the program. Okay. So as you can see that we have taken four elements. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, and the such you have taken. Sorry, you have taken 5 elements. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And the position of first element is 0. And suppose the position of last element is 4. Okay, so first is 0 and last is 4. Okay, so we have found the middle. So middle is 0 plus 4 by 2. Okay, that is 2. Okay. So it is 2. Okay, so we will check whether while if first is less than equal to last or not. Okay, so if first is less than equal to last, that means there are some elements in the list. Okay, so next we will check. We have basically three conditions: whether array is greater than, array middle is greater than such, or array middle is equals to such, or less than such. Okay, so we have basically three parts. So if array middle is less than such, then it will shift, or there is new list will be created, and the new list will be, in the new list, the low, high, the last part will be same, but the first part will be middle plus 1. Okay, so now else if section. Okay, there is another condition, that is whether array middle is equals to such or not. Okay, so if array middle is equals to such, then we can say that the element is found. Okay, and if the element is found, there is a break statement, that is we did not require to check further. Okay, in the next else part, that is the part that is, this was, this part was array middle is less than such, and in the else part, that is array middle is greater than such. So if the array middle is greater than such, then the new list will be left hand side of the middle part. Okay, so in that case, first will be same, but last will be middle minus 1. Okay, and after that we will find the value of middle, that is first plus last by 2. Okay, so if first is greater than last, okay, then we can say that element is found, otherwise the element is not found. Okay, so this was the program to check whether a number exists in the list or not using binary search. Okay, so hope you have understood. So students, this was the program to check whether a number is exist in the array or not using binary searching. Okay, so this is a very important one. Okay, binary search. Okay, hope you have understood it. Okay, if you have any doubt, any query, you can write on the comment section. Okay, or if you like my videos, you can subscribe my channel. Okay, or you can visit www.facebook.com/digitalclassroomniladripal. Okay, and like my page. Okay, so students, thank you for now. See you in the next video tutorial. Thank you.